Today you're going to learn about FIFO, which is short for first in, first out. Now what does it really mean though? And why do we need something like this in the first place? So here's the problem. You're selling these nice dresses in your store for $200 each. You're sourcing them from your standard supplier in Italy. The purchase price your supplier charges is different for each order. It depends on the price for the raw material, exchange rates, and so on. When you ordered the dresses the first time, you paid $50 per unit. The next order was $55 per dress, and on your last order, you ended up paying $60 per unit. Each time, you order 30 dresses. Because of the lockdown, you still have 70 dresses from these purchases in your stock. You only sold 20 so far. But thankfully, yesterday, you could reopen your store and you were already able to sell 15 of the dresses for $200. Now you're wondering, what was my profit for this sale? Let's break it down together. We know that revenue minus cost of goods sold equals gross profit. Your revenue was $3,000, the sales price for the 15 dresses. Cost of goods sold is the price you had to pay to your supplier in Italy. But remember, the price was different each time you bought from him. So what do you think? Do we need to deduct $50, $55, or $60 per dress as cost of goods sold? Let's find out. In a perfect world, we would assign unique barcodes to each of the dresses. And then our accounting and inventory system can match the barcode with the exact cost at which each dress was purchased. So when we sell a dress, the system knows, okay, that specific dress, color white, size M, was purchased with our second order from Italy. This means the cost was $55. In accounting terms, that's called specific identification method. It's the most accurate method, but as you can imagine, it's quite complex. In reality, businesses rarely have the resources to maintain such a system. So they have to use a method that's easier to apply. That's where FIFO comes in. FIFO is one of three cost flow assumptions. The other two are LIFO, which means last in, first out, and AFCO, which stands for average cost. The important word here is assumption, which means it's an approximation and doesn't necessarily reflect reality. The principle behind FIFO is that products which came in first are the first to go out. Now, for most businesses, that actually will be the case because they're going to want to sell their old items first, especially when the products have a shelf life. That's why FIFO usually is a good assumption for the physical flow of goods. So let's come back to your dress sales and figure out what is the cost of goods sold. Remember, you purchased three batches for the dresses. In round one, you paid $50 per unit, the second time was $55, and the last batch was for $60. You need to identify the cost of goods sold for the 15 dresses that you sold yesterday. Like we said, with FIFO, we assume that the first product we bought is the first to go out. So from the first purchase of 30 dresses at $50 each, we already sold 20 before the lockdown. So the next 10 dresses still get the cost from this purchase. But you sold 15 yesterday, so 5 dresses will get the cost from the second purchase at $55 each. 10 times 50 is $500, and 5 times 55 is $275. In total, cost of goods sold of $775. So our income statement would look like this. Revenue is $3,000, that's 15 dresses for $200, minus $775 as cost of goods sold. This results in gross profit of $2,225. We got here using the FIFO method. Now, which method to use is an important decision for a business to make because it influences profits. For example, if we were to apply the LIFO method, which is last in, first out, we would use the value from the latest purchase for cost of goods sold. In our case, LIFO means we take the cost for 10 of the dresses from the last purchase, which was at $60 per dress. Then for 5 dresses, we take the cost from the second purchase, which was at $55. In total, cost of goods sold of $875. So based on the LIFO method, our profit would be $2,125, $100 less than with FIFO. That's important to remember. Usually, we'll see rising prices due to inflation. There will be exceptions, but for the most part, the same item we bought last year is going to be more expensive today. And because with FIFO, we're applying the prices from the earlier purchases, businesses using FIFO are considered more profitable, at least on paper. Just like we saw in our example, the same business transactions showed a profit of $2,225 with FIFO, but only $2,125 with LIFO. Of course, higher profits are great to impress investors, but it also probably increases the amount of taxes that a company has to pay. So that's something to consider too. And no, you can't pick a different method each year based on your requirements. So once you choose FIFO or any other method, you're expected to stick with it for the next years. Now, while we're on a roll, let's answer another question. What is the value for the ending inventory that we still have in stock at the end of the day? In our example, you purchased 90 dresses and sold 20 before the lockdown. Yesterday, you sold another 15, which means you are left with an inventory of 55 units. Because we're applying FIFO, we're assuming that we're selling from the oldest stock first. So consequently, the cost for these 55 dresses left in inventory must be taken from the most recent purchases. Remember, we first bought 30 dresses for $50, then another 30 for $55, and last 30 for $60. So the value for the 55 dresses in ending inventory is calculated like this. We take the full value from the last purchase of 30 dresses, that's $1,800. We have 55 in inventory, so the remaining 25 dresses will be valued at the cost of the previous purchase, which was $55. 25 times 55 is $1,375. Total ending inventory is $3,175. So that's FIFO. Now remember, it's a cost flow assumption. So it's an approximation, and the physical flow of goods doesn't necessarily need to reflect the first in, first out principle. In most cases, it's going to give you higher profits than if you were to apply the LIFO or the average cost method. FIFO is accepted both under GAAP and IFRS, so it can be used for US and internationally based financial statements. And in all cases where FIFO is used, cost of goods sold and the ending inventory value would be the same at the end of the month, regardless of whether a perpetual or periodic inventory system is used. Now, I hope this video was helpful to understand the FIFO method a little bit better. If you liked what you saw, please give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you want to improve your skills. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.